the organizers for giving me this chance. This is the paper of Dr. Moria, since he was to leave for an urgent work, so I am presenting on his behalf. Eyes and face are the third most common organs affected by trauma after hands and feet world over. 24 lakh ocular injuries occur every year in India, and 5 lakh of them results in blindness. 16 lakh people are blind due to ocular trauma. This is a 4.4% of total blind population. 50% of eye casualties cases are related to ocular trauma, and around 10% of admitted cases are in the any in a hospital are related to ocular injuries. 24% injuries related blindness in North India is because of the sports. Anterior segment is more commonly involved, but pure posterior segment injuries are also seen in around 10% of the patient. Average age of the sports-related injury in India is 24 years as compared to 16 in the Western world. To 47% of ocular injuries achieve less than 60 vision, and 10% are legally blind. Sports can be categorized depending on the norms of the sports. Conventional sports which have no set norms like baseball, which have set norms like baseball, hockey, cricket, football, golf, and sports where there are no set norms, with uncontrolled and erratic behavior of the players, bow and arrow injuries, gulel, cracker, bombs. Injuries can also, these sports can also be categorized depending on their popularities. The modern games like cricket, hockey, football, tennis, golf, boxing, and old traditional games like gulli danda, kabaddi, bow and arrow. And depending on the anticipated eye damage, these sports can be divided into low-risk sports where there are no use of gadgets and minimum body contact like swimming, gymnastics, cycling, and high-risk where the gadgets are used and body contact is there, cricket, hockey, tennis, football, and very high-risk sports where there is a strenuous body contact, boxing, wrestling, martial art. And in this category, I would like to add archery and hammer throw, etc. In the recently concluded national games at Guwahati, we had two very serious cases. In one case, the whole of the hammer passed through the head, and in another case, a whole of the bow passed through the head. That is in the during the well-organized games. These are the traditional games, gulli danda, bow and arrow injuries, modern games where there is a lot of touch with the face and lot of damage. Ball injuries. In India, cricket is very famous. Cricket is played both by the solid leather ball and the tennis ball. Both have a different kind of a presentation. The cricket, solid cricket ball have more bony injuries, whereas the tennis ball injuries are more of a globe injuries, and they come many times with the total rupture of the globe. Shuttlecock injuries, because the shuttlecock fits quite well in the orbital cavity, these cases also come with the serious ruptures. Many famous cricketers like Sabah Kareem, they lost their eyes because of the cricket ball injuries. Fighting during the cricket matches are very common in India, and they can result in severe serious injuries. Some hockey players have also lost their eyes because of these injuries. Oculofacial injuries are very common in high impact, high contact games like rugby balls. An interesting case of fish hook injury. This boy was standing behind a man who was fishing, and during one of the attraction process, this hook arrowed into his eye, and he had it in the central cornea, presented with corneal edema. It was removed under GA through a vertical skin retrograde technique, advanced eye cut technique, and vertical eyelid split techniques. They are can be used in these things. Eye injuries, fish hook injuries are uncommon, but they are serious. How to prevent these sports-related injury? Sports trauma should always be taken seriously because they have very unfavorable outcome. avoid dangerous games, sportsmen need to follow the guidelines very strictly. They need to follow the rules of games very strictly. The protective gadgets need to be designed and provided to them. And one of them may be polycarbonate shatterproof lenses. Road traffic accidents are common occurrence every day, growing day by day because of growing vehicles, poor roads, new drivers, many reasons the road traffic accident is increasing. Road traffic accident is the ninth most common cause of death worldwide. 12 lakh people die globally due to road traffic accidents. India accounts for 7% of these cases. Mortality rate is 7 to 80 per 100 vehicles in India, and more than 70,000 people die, and nearly 4 lakhs are injured in the road traffic accidents every day in India. These cases need to be tackled, as Dr. Shalu has also enumerated, proper inspection, palpation, special examination, special assessment of both anterior segment, posterior segment, optic nerve, ocular muscles. And these cases need to be taken on case-to-case basis so that they can be provided with good outcome, whether in the terms of visual rehabilitation or cosmesis. How to prevent? Educate the common man, common people about the roadside accidents and prevent provision of the first aid and resuscitation, strict implementation of the traffic rules, and encouraging and to encourage them to use the appropriate safety measures like helmets, seat belts, airbags, avoiding driving under the difficult conditions, preoccupied thoughts, drowsy driving, drive fatigue, sleepiness in the daytime, fast driving, overload driving, eating while driving, and of course, alcohol. So the public should be educated about the importance of eye. They should be motivated to utilize the health services in case of trauma as soon as possible. School teachers need to be sensitized about the injuries, about the prevention, and about the early treatment. The mass health education programs need to be there. There should be awareness about the risk of ocular trauma and morbidity caused due to delayed presentation and delayed reporting and delayed sort of the health care. The appropriate use of protective devices should be encouraged. Thank you.